So, a very good morning to everyone. I, Deepika Bhatia, Program Coordinator, welcome you all on behalf of Anon Global Foundation for the final presentation session for 15 days internship program offered by Anon. I'm sure all the interns must have had their best of efforts in these 15 days training program and has an extraordinary experience while working on their topics. I welcome our jury members, Ms. Payal Upal. She has 18 years of experience in educating and effectively communicating with students from diverse backgrounds, motivated average students to fully explore their potential and produced the highest individual score tally in the district in English CBSE higher secondary boards. She has also nurtured talent as the chief editor of the school magazine and newsletter for the last 18 years. I welcome you, ma'am, and welcome, ma'am. I also would like to introduce Ms. Jyoti Bajaj. Jyoti Bajaj is a gold medalist special educator from Lady Irwin College, Delhi, Delhi University, and gold medalist physiotherapist from Kurukshetra University. She is working as a special educator and counselor with DPS Rohini since last 5 years. She excels in promoting mental health awareness and training and has conducted several training programs, webinars, and interactive sessions with students, parents, and teachers on the subject. A warm welcome, ma'am. I thank both the jury members for their valuable time. Now, moving on. As we all are well aware that our team of interns was divided amongst 10 groups and has been allocated 10 different topics. So today, we have team Inception with us who will be sharing their ideas on the topic Sleep, the Magic Potion of Well-Being. The team is mentored by Ms. Khanak Lashkari. We have Arush Arora from Delhi. We have Yash Lashkare, Rajasthan. Panash Madan from Delhi. Ojas Kapoor from Delhi. Bhaskar Gupta from Delhi. Now, I request the team to please come forward and kindly start the presentation.
Good morning, everyone. So today in front of you, we are going to present our 15 days of hard work on the topic, Sleep, the Magic Potion of Well-Being. Our team consists of our mentor, Khanak Lashkare, our participants, I, Ojas Kapoor, Panash Madan, Yash Lashkare, and Arush Arora. Our topic for this presentation is going to be Sleep, the Magic Potion of Well-Being. What happens when we sleep? No one can answer this question, so I am going to brief you about it. When we sleep, our body temperature starts to decrease, our eye movements stop, your heart rate and muscles start to relax, and your brain waves spike and then slow down, and most importantly, giving you a smile and on your face for the next morning.
Why sleep is important? Sleep is important because it enables the body to repair and be fit for the another day. Getting rest also helps to prevent excess weight gain and heart disease and increase the illness duration. While sleeping, our body undergoes a series of changes that enables the body to vital for our health. The recommended amount of sleep for an adult is 8 to 10 hours. Function at best. Getting enough sleep helps you to think, react, work, learn, and get along with others. What are the benefits of sleep? There are many benefits of sleep. First, when your body gets the sleep, it needs your immune cell and protein to get rest. They need to fight whatever comes on their way, like cold or the flu. Second, sleep can stand your heart. Lack of sleep can cause your body to release some stress hormones that can lead your heart to work harder. Third, better sleep can lead to better mood. People who sleep between 8 and 9 hours during the night tends to wake up happier. Fourth, sleep can improve productivity. If a person gets more sleep, then they are more focused and better at performing tasks. Therefore, they get the more done and can feel better about their work. Fifth, sleep can reduce stress. Sleep is a powerful stress reducer. Following a regular sleep routine calms or restores the body. Now, we will be present a movie which we have to try to show importance of sleep and how sleep is the magic potion of well-being.
Sleep, the magic potion of well-being. I totally agree to this statement because whenever I have a wound or a problem, it helps me recover from that or get the solution. From sleep, I also get refreshed every day and it helps me to remove all the negative thoughts from my mind. Sleep is a boon for us and for everybody because we get a new start for the day after sleeping. Our sleep also helps us recover from many problems like finding a solution or helping us cure a wound. Without sleep, our mind will be full of thoughts, and sleep always helps us be fresh every day. So I totally agree to this statement. Sleep is the magic potion of well-being.
Optimizing our waking hours, but what about the precious hours after we doze off, as the most active time for our brains and the most important element to a calmer, happier life? Sleep has become the topic of our times. A good night's sleep is incredibly important for your health. In fact, it's just as important as eating healthy and exercising. Unfortunately, there's a lot that can interfere with natural sleep patterns. People are now sleeping less than they did in the past, and sleep quality has decreased as well. Here are a few reasons why good sleep is important. Number one, poor sleep is strongly related to weight gain. Number two, good sleepers tend to eat fewer calories. Number three, good sleep can improve concentration and productivity. Sleep is important for various aspects of brain function. It includes concentration, productivity, and performance.
It's extremely late at night, but I'm not able to sleep. Let's pass my time by using some electronics. It is 1 o'clock, but still, I'm not able to sleep. Good morning. I don't think I slept well last night. It's the morning, but I'm still not able to concentrate on my work. I should have slept early last night. It's 9 o'clock and I'm going to bed because I know that I wasn't able to get much sleep last night. So I realized that I should start sleeping early.
is the best position to sleep. Sleep is a big part of our lives. Even if we are not getting 8 hours, but there's more to it than you might think. If you're having problems getting enough sleep or have an injury, there's more to it than laying down. Your sleep position plays a big role in your sleep quality. So it might be time for you to switch it up. In the front sleeping position, sleeping with a flat pillow under the pelvis and stomach can help keep the spine in alignment. Sleeping with a flat pillow or without a pillow under the head may also promote better alignment of the spine. Other postures can create neck sprains and other posture weaknesses. Facts about sleep. 12% of the people dream in black and white. Go back a half century, and television's impact on our closed eye experiences become even clearer. In the 1940s, studies showed that 3/4 of Americans, including college students, reported rarely or never seeing any color in their dreams. 2/3 of a cat's life is spent sleeping. A bat needs 20 hours of sleep every day. Humans spend 1/3 of their life sleeping. A good night's sleep is vital for every human being to survive. Given that on average, a person sleeps for 8 hours in a day. That means that an average person will sleep for 229,961 hours in their lifetime, or basically 1/3 of their entire life. 15% of the population are sleepwalkers. Average time to fall asleep is 15 minutes. The normal time it takes most people to fall asleep is between 10 and 20 minutes. And of course, there are certain nights this time may be more or less. But if you fall asleep too quickly or if it takes beyond a half hour, most nights to drift into dreamland, there may be an underlying issue to consider. Humans are the only mammals that willingly delay sleep. And last but not the least, sleeping on your front can aid digestion.
Sleep is the best meditation. In fact, a good laugh and long sleep are the two best cures for anything. As you can see in the slide being presented, there can be serious consequences on our health if we don't sleep. Number one, we feel tired and lethargic the whole day. Number two, we tend to forget stuff. Number three, it can also increase the risk of getting cancer and diabetes. Number four, we can gain weight. And number five, we can't think and concentrate properly. As you can see in the digital poster made by me, lack of sleep can lead to serious diseases like obesity and heart failure. A good and deep sleep leads to better productivity and a fresh and refreshed day ahead.
So this is an illustration made by me representing all the factors and importance of sleep. As you can see in the illustration, sleep increases memory. Sleep increases our memory so that we can have a nice and healthy next day. Sleep also brings energy for us so that we can hard work next day. Sleep heals wounds naturally. Sleep is the best way to cure our wound naturally, and it is the best way for me to cure any wound till now also. Sleep also brings freshness. Sleep brings freshness and a smile on our face for the next healthy and nice morning.
This is in a digital model by me. In this model, there is written, your futures depend on your dreams, so go to sleep. By this line, I meant having a good sleep can lead to your future. But the question arises here that, how does are there even relate? As we know that good sleep can make sure to good dreams, and good to complete that dream, sleep increase our efficiency, which is eventually increase our productivity, which led us to achieve our goals.
my poster, which shows a little cute baby sleeping. He's enjoying the best of his life by sleeping on top of the moon. That also makes me fall asleep. A good sleep position affects our sleep as well. And I'm sure that the baby is having some sweet dreams.
Now we are going to head to the sub-analysis. We circulated a Google form which we circulated among the family and friends, out of which 56.1% of the respondents were female, 39% were male, and the rest were prefer not to sit. The ages which filled the survey were 55.6% above 30, 16% 18 to 30, and 28.3% below 18. The first question we asked the respondents was, what among the following according to you is the best way to fall asleep? The four options were drinking coffee, reading books, listening to relaxing music, and none of the above, out of which 51.3% answered listening to relaxing music, 24.1% answered reading books, 11.2% answered none of the above, and the rest answered drinking coffee and others. The second question we asked was, what among the following activities you do to ensure a healthy sleep? The four options were, stay away from caffeine and alcohol late in the day, go to sleep and get up at the same time, get at least 7 hours of sleep, and none of the above, out of which 55.1% answered get at least 7 hours of sleep, 25.7% answered go to sleep and get up at the same time, and 12.3% answered stay away from phone, and the rest answered none of the above.
So, the third question come here is the, how often do you feel sleepy in the day while working? The objective of this question is, how often you are sleepy while working on day? How many people are there then who's sleepy while working? From 187 people, 68% of people saying always, 46% of people saying sometimes, 32.6% of people saying rarely, and 13.4% of people are saying never. The fourth question come here is the, how long do you take fall asleep once you are in a bed? How much time you are sleeping once you are in the bed? From 187 people, 11.8% of people saying more than an hour, 34.8% of people saying less than 15 minutes, 40.6% of people are saying around half an hour, and 12.8% of people are saying 1 hour.
Fifth question is that, do you have dreams while you are sleeping? And the objective of this question was to know that how many of our respondents dream at night. Having dreams also prove that you are having a good deep sleep, which is healthy for us. And 58.8% of our respondents answered that they dream sometimes, while 12.8% replied rarely, and 23% replied that they always get dreams, and hardly anyone told that they never get dreams. The sixth question is that, what do you do when you wake up in the midnight? We asked this question in a survey to get to know that what people decide to do if they wake up in the middle of the night. Their health will depend on their choice. And most of the people responded that they try to go to sleep. And on the other hand, 15% of the people answered that they use gadgets, 7.5% of the people decided to do something else, and hardly any people decided to stay awake.
Do you think sleep helps you to get healed with stress and anxiety? The main motive for this question was to know that does sleep really help you in healing with stress and anxiety? An astonishing 77% said yes, sleep helps in healing with stress and anxiety. 17.1% of the people said sometimes, and only a few people said that no and rarely. Do you have negative thoughts while falling asleep or positive thoughts? We asked this question to get to know that Are they having positive or negative thoughts while they go to sleep for starting a new fresh day? 54% of the people said both. 21.9% of the people said positive. 10.2% of the people said negative. And 13.9% of the people said none of the above. Has sleeping ever helped you in finding a solution to a problem? So the main motive for asking this question was so that we can know that sleeping has ever helped you in finding a solution to a problem. So 43.9% of the people said yes. 25.1% of the people said maybe. 17.6% of the people said I don't remember. And 13.4% of the people said never. Is sleep actually a magic potion of well-being according to you? So this question is the main motive of our presentation, to know that is sleep actually a magic potion of well-being. So mostly all of the people out of 187 responses, 84.5% of the people said yes, sleep is the magic potion of well-being, which we five also agree. 11.2% of the people said maybe, and only few people said no, sleep is not the magic potion of well-being. What is a good quality sleep? A healthy sleep, which is a sleep which helps in curing your wounds and problems naturally and keeps you healthy. For example, adults should optimally receive between 7 and 9 hours of sleep each night, but those needs vary individually. For example, some people feel best with 8 consecutive hours of sleep, while others do well with 6 to 7 hours at night and daytime napping. What is a good quality sleep? Here are some factors that signify that you have a good quality sleep or not. Sleeping more time while in bed, at least 85% of the total time. Falling asleep in 30 minutes or less. Waking up no more than once per night. And being awake for 20 minutes or less after initially falling asleep are some factors that you are having a good sleep.
How does sleep affect well-being? Sleep allows our body to repair themselves and our brain to consolidate our memories and process information. Poor sleep is linked to physical problems such as weakened immune system and mental health problems such as anxiety and depression. Skimping on sleep can cause concentration problems, drowsiness, and irritable moods that affect the way you work. Longitudinal studies suggest that insomnia and other sleep problems worsen before an episode of mania or bipolar depression, and lack of sleep can trigger mania. Sleep is as important to our health as eating, drinking, or breathing.
Sleep plays a major role in our physical exercises. Sleep is important in healing of heart. Sleep deficiency is linked to heart diseases like heart failure and heart attack. Also, other things like kidney diseases and diabetes. Key factors of getting good sleep. Sleep can boost your immune system, which helps you fight diseases. Getting 9 hours of sleep can help prevent weight gain. Sleep can strengthen your heart, which decreases the chances of heart attacks and heart failures. Better sleep equals better mood and fresh mind and a fresh day ahead. Sleeping can increase productivity of working. Lack of sleep can be dangerous and can cause many diseases like obesity. Sleep can increase exercise performance. And finally, sleep improves memory and concentration.
Five unconventional sleep tips. First, exercise during the day. Some research has found that exercise anytime during the day can help to promote a good night's sleep. Second, having an early dinner. The best time to have a dinner is 2 to 3 hours before going to bed. Otherwise, it will produce harmful syndromes in your body. Third, go to bed at the same time every night. Sleeping at same time strengthens your sleeping routine and it helpful to achieve good quality sleep. Fourth, Make sure your matter is comfortable. The type of matter that you are use and impact the quality of your sleep. Uncomfortable matters can cause back pain. Fifth, replace worries with positive thoughts. Negative thoughts may keep you away from falling asleep, so replace them with positive thoughts.
All you need is a sleep. Sleep restores energy, repairs tissues, and heals our body, enhances memory and cognitive skills. It helps in body growth and finally lends a glow to our faces for a fresh and healthy morning. Nobody, and I would also have not imagined that we would have so many things achieved from just sleeping, which is a daily routine of our life.
Subtleties about sleep that can help us even more. Experts agree that most adults need an average of about 7 to 9 hours of sleep each night for optimal health. A recent study out of the University of Binghamton revealed twofold research that found that subjects who slept less were more likely to experience repetitive negative. Was that this was also true of subjects who got enough sleep but got it later at night, suggesting that not just the amount of sleep, but the timing of that sleep is critical. Humans appear to be built for nighttime sleeping, despite what self-proclaimed night owls might claim. UC Berkeley neuroscientist Matthew Walker designed an experiment which demonstrated inadequate sleep causes the emotional centers of the brain to run amok. When viewing images from neutral to disturbing subjects in his trial became 60% more reactive to negative pictures compared to subjects who were well rested, which means that not sleeping enough or not. Sleep affect mental health. Sleep has a direct relationship with these three most important aspects of mental health. First, stress. If you have ever struggled to get through the day after a night of tossing and turning, you are well acquainted with the disruptive effects of sleep deprivation. Mood changes, including increased irritability and anger, can make it much harder to cope with even the minor stress of daily life. Second, anxiety. As with many other psychological conditions, the relationship between sleep and anxiety appears to go both directions. People with anxiety tend to experience more sleep disturbances, but experiencing sleep deprivation can also contribute to feelings of anxiety. This can become a cycle that perpetuates both the sleep and anxiety issues. Third, depression. Insomnia and other sleep problems can be a symptom of depression. But more recently, the research has implicated the lack of sleep in actually causing depression. The impact of chronic sleepiness. First, sleepiness slows down your thought processes. Scientists measuring sleepiness have found that sleep deprivation leads to lower alertness and concentration. It is more difficult to focus and pay attention, so you are more easily confused. This hampers your ability to perform tasks that require logical reasoning or complex thought. Second, excessive sleepiness impairs memory. Research suggests that the nerve connections that make our sleep memories are strengthened during the sleep. Sleep embeds the things that we have learned and experienced over the course of the day into our short-term memory. It appears that different phases of sleep play different roles in consolidating new information into the memories of your sleep. If your sleep is cut short or disrupted, it interferes with these cycles. Third, Poor sleep makes learning difficult. Sleep deprivation affects your ability to learn in two ways. Because you can't focus as well, it's more difficult to pick up information. So you can't learn.
What is the biggest danger of sleepiness? Slowed reaction time. Sleepiness makes your reaction time slower. A special problem when driving or doing work or other tasks that require a quick response. The National Highway Traffic Safety Administration conservatively estimates that at least 100,000 crashes reported to police each year are due to driver fatigue. Other estimates that number at 1 million, 20% of all crashes. Nearly one-third of Americans in the National Sleep Foundation's 2009 poll reported nodding off while driving. You don't need to fall asleep at the wheel to be a danger. Drowsiness alone can be as dangerous as driving drunk. Driving while sleepy is like driving with a blood alcohol content of 0.08%, over the legal limit in many states, and drinking and drowsiness are double trouble when driving because sleep deprivation magnifies the effects of alcohol.
Suggestions to improve sleep. Here are some suggestions so that you can improve your daily sleep and have a nice and healthy life. Stick to a sleep schedule. Set aside no more than 8 hours for sleep. The recommended amount of sleep for a healthy adult is at least 7 hours. Most people don't need more than 8 hours in bed to achieve this goal. Go to bed and get up at the same time every day. Try to limit the difference in your sleep schedule on weeknights and weekends to no more than 1 hour. Being consistent reinforces your body's sleep-wake cycle. Second, pay attention to what you eat and drink. Don't go to bed hungry or stuffed. In particular, avoid heavy or large meals within a couple of hours of bedtime. Your discomfort might keep you up. Nicotine, caffeine, and alcohol deserve caution too. The stimulating effects of nicotine and caffeine take hours to wear off and can wreak havoc in quality sleep. And even though alcohol might make you feel sleepy, it can disrupt sleep later in the night. Third, create a restful environment. Create a room that's ideal for sleeping. Often this means cool, dark, and quiet. Exposure to light might make it more challenging to fall asleep. Avoid prolonged use of light-emitting screens just before bedtime. Consider using room darkening shades, earplugs, a fan, or other devices to create an environment that suits your needs. During calming activities before bedtime, such as taking a bath or using relaxation techniques, might promote better sleep. Limit daytime naps. Long daytime naps can interfere with nighttime sleep. If you choose to nap, limit yourself to up to 30 minutes and avoid doing so late in the day. If you work nights, however, you might need to nap late in the day before work to help up your sleep depth. Fifth, include physical activity in your daily routine. Regular physical activity can promote better sleep. Avoid being active too close to bedtime. However, spending time outside every day might be helpful too. Sixth, manage worries. Try to resolve your worries or concerns before bedtime. Jot down what's on your mind and then set it aside for tomorrow. Stress management might help. Start with the basics, such as getting organized, setting priorities, and delegating tasks. Meditation also can ease your anxiety.
Conclusion. First, sleep can boost your immune system. During sleep, your immune system releases protein called cytotoxins, and some of which help promote to sleep. Second, sleep can strengthen your body. Research said that good sleep can strengthen your immune system. Third, good sleep, good mood. After a sleepless night, you may be more interruptible, short-tempered, and stress will be removed. Fourth, sleep can improve productivity. Mountaineering evidence suggests that a good night's sleep can seriously boost productivity. Fifth, lack of sleep can be dangerous. If it continues, lack of sleep can affect your overall health and make your phone to serious medical condition. Sixth, sleep can increase performance. As we know, sleep increases work efficiency, it increases performance, and sleep can increase memory also.
We learned a lot along the way of this 15-day internship. Teamwork, responsibility, time management, improving productivity, sleep well, live better, and researching. Teamwork was very important as many of the times our slides got deleted, but we all got them back as they were never removed. Responsibility, to complete the task we were assigned. Time management, to take out time to complete the slides. Improving productivity. Sleep, the magic portion of well-being, which was a topic, allowed us to learn better how to sleep well and live better. And finally, researching on subtopics more deeply and briefly. And finally, I would like to thank Anand Global Foundation and YWCA India for this opportunity on the behalf of my team. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Team Inception, for the wonderful presentation. Now, I would like to request Payal ma'am to share her views regarding the presentation and move on with the question answer round.
Thank you, Deepika ma'am. And thank you, children. Your presentation was done with a lot of research. And I'm very sure that you must have spent sleepless nights trying to find out how to sleep well. So very well done. And I think Anand is doing a wonderful job in picking up such pertinent topics related to teenagers and young minds. If you are able to balance out sleep, I'm sure you're going to head the world very soon. So Kanak, I think that you've done a very good job as far as research and mentoring to the students has been concerned. I'll put a very simple question to you. Very often, children, you sleep, but when you get up, you're still very tired. You have touched on these things in your presentation. I would like you to once again take it up that why is it that our body is still asking us to sleep though we've slept for good 8 hours? Our mind says that. If any one of you can answer.
Yeah, so I would like to answer that we feel tired again after sleeping because when we work very hard, we feel tired a lot of time. And then if we don't go to sleep very quickly, then we might need more sleep and we might sleep insufficiently. So that is the reason why we feel sleepy afterwards also. So this was the conclusion to the topic. So if you need to stay healthy, then go to sleep early and then finish all your goals and your dreams and become big in the world after sleeping.
Okay. I would like to add on to this. As in the survey, we also asked the question, what among the following activities we do to ensure a healthy sleep? So we asked that question to ensure that people sleep well.
Aarti ma'am, can I ask another question? The other thing that I have is, Beta, you all know that we have a corporate culture that has invaded all countries globally, and their sleep has crashed. You know, when we have no timing for as far as the corporate culture is concerned, we need to progress economically, we need to move and be part of the global mandate. So how does a young mind balance this time zone culture? My question to you is that.
Can you repeat?
How does the young mind balance the corporate time zone culture with sleep?
I would like to answer, as I said in the PPT as well, what we learned along the way. this internship allowed us to take out time, and that is called time management, and I learned to manage my time way better than I used to.
And also, when in the earlier times, everybody was healthy and they also used to manage time very nicely, better than us. This technology, we have so much technology that, and due to lockdown also, we don't go to play outside also. We just start playing on our mobile or laptops and then we just start playing. So this way we can't do anything. So when the lockdown ends, we will make a timetable for everything and we will start managing time so that we can take out time for every single thing.
Thank you, Ojas. Thank you, Arush.
And
well answered.
I would like to add to Arush and Ojas. I agree to both of them. And making a timetable is really important for us to manage our time. And time management should be managed very well.
Thank you, Lyndon. Thank you so much. Jyoti ma'am, they're all yours now.
Thank you, ma'am, for your enlightening words. Jyoti ma'am, please share your views regarding the presentation and any question you would like to ask from our interns.
Thank you. Thank you, Deepika ma'am. Very well done, children. It was a wonderful presentation and it was so lively and lovely to see young minds talking. Talking especially about the life skills. I think that's the learning that you've got, and I really wish and hope that you take this learning forward in your life, and this really helps you to be better people forward. The way you connected the things with time management, each one of you wanted to give your input there. That was really heartwarming. The presentation was very good. It showed your dedication, your teamwork, and like Payal ma'am said, you really must have put sleepless nights to understand the importance of sleep to put this presentation together. I really appreciate the work all four of you have put together, Ojas, Panash, Yash, Arush, and definitely a compliment to Khannak as well to monitor them, to supervise them and guide them to put this presentation together. I really like the anecdote that you had put in your presentation. Your future depends on your dream, so you should sleep more. I would have liked to go on this discussion. You know, your survey also said that 58 plus 12, 70% of people do not dream or rarely dream when they are asleep. But the way Ojas connected it with saying that, you know, we need to have our dreams and aspirations, and to actually achieve the dreams and aspirations, we need to sleep more. So I really hope and wish that you understand the importance of sleep. Well done, children. I was just going through a research article yesterday which said that more than 50% of teenagers, in fact, it said around 68% of teenagers nowadays, they have difficulty falling asleep. And it also did mention about the role of gadgets, you know, especially in the current times when people have gone online for everything. The gadgets probably have a much more stimulant effect in letting you sleep. My question to you is, what do you think are the major causes that are causing problems like sleep deprivation or insomnia in young adults, especially in teenagers in your age? What do you think are the major causes that are leading to sleep deprivation?
So the main reason is, yeah, you speak first. Sorry.
Okay. We use gadgets and that's why we are lacking by our sleep. And our sleep is really important and everyone should understand this. And I wish I could tell this to everybody. Usage of gadgets should be less.
Yeah, so the main reason why using gadgets, because it is a mystery that why gadgets decrease our sleep healthiness. This is because gadgets give us radiations which are too harmful for young children especially. So this problem is for teenagers, that and during the night also our mothers is to sleep and then we use our gadgets late in the night, and those harmful radiations are the main cause to this unfortunate question.
And while in the night many teenagers use the mobile and laptops, and their screen affects their eyes, so they does not also get the sleep. While they close their eyes and they think anything, they think what happened in my game I was playing, what happened that, what who will post now next video on YouTube. So that's all of the thing led us not to sleep, and we not sleep, and the next day we are not concentrating to our studies, etc. All whatever we are doing, we are not concentrable, and we are not eventually so we don't get efficiency of sleep that eventually increase our productivities also.
I would like to add on to Yashan. I totally agree to what he said, like if you have a favorite YouTuber and you're just waiting him to post something, that increases your flow state and that doesn't allow you to sleep.
Yeah, thank you, children. It's really great to hear your views. So another takeaway from this presentation, from the research that you've done, is when you were talking about tips to have better sleep or strategies to improve sleep, I must add to this that it is mandatory for everybody, not just you children, for everybody, we as adults also. We need to be off our gadgets at least 2 hours prior to sleeping, because it really kind of activates your hormones. There is something called as blood-brain barrier, which leads to a lot of neurotransmitters being exchanged at your brain level. And it is said that the stimulants, the gadgets, or maybe the games that you play, or even social media, the WhatsApp, the Instagram, the Facebook, you know, I have seen that people have generally started having this tendency to just take up their phone, scroll through all the social media, and you know that kind of makes a part of their routine. So it is very important for us all to be off the gadgets for some hours during the day. We should have, say, you know, I've always been saying this in my sessions also, it's important to be off the gadgets for at least 2 hours a day, wherein we sit as a family, or even if we are busy in our own lives, you know, at least those 2 hours are no gadget hours. And especially before going to sleep, to have a good night's sleep, to actually, like, you know, the question that Payal ma'am also asked, why even after having, 7 to 8 hours of sleep, when we get up, we still feel sleepy. You'd also mentioned about chronic sleepiness in your slides. I was really impressed to learn that word from you. There is a difference between sleep and sleepiness. And yes, these stimulants, they actually lead to chronic sleepiness. So it's important to be off gadgets, especially 2 hours before going to sleep. Well researched. My one more question, which I wanted to put across. You had mentioned about night owls in your presentation, and actually, children, that is something that we as counselors are encountering recently, of late. We when we talk to our children from classes 11 and 12, we see that their circadian rhythm, you know, the body cycle is changing. They do take sleep for good, 8 to 9 hours or 7 to 8 hours, but they sleep at 3 a.m. and they get up by 11 a.m. So do you think, that's right? I mean, you talked about 7 to 8 hours of sleep. They are taking 7 to 8 hours of sleep, but this change in the timings, becoming night owls, what is your opinion on it? What do you think? Is it okay to just have good uninterrupted 7 to 8 hours of sleep, or is it important to have fixed sleeping hours wherein you go by the age old long proverb, early to bed, early to rise makes man healthy, wealthy and wise. So just need your take on this.
Actually, ma'am, in our presentation we have said this, that it is this is good to take 8 to 9 hours sleep, but they should also have a sleeping routine. Sometimes person sleeping on 2 a.m., sometimes on 3 a.m. So it will concentrate on his mind also. So that's why the proper sleep routine also should be there while you are using electronics in midnight, you are seeing YouTube, any day you sleep on 2 a.m., next day you are sleeping on 3 a.m., and other day you are sleeping on 10 a.m. only, so it's not a proper routine. So that's why this is not good for our health, and this is not healthy sleep because we does not have proper sleep routine also.
And I agree to that. I agree to Yash completely. And we should sleep early so that as we also have other work to do other than sleeping. And a good night's sleep is completely important. But also, on the other hand, we have to complete our tasks and the daily jobs.
And also, I just recalled something that when we were taking the survey analysis, we were happy that 77% of the people tried to sleep when they woke up. But 20% of the people used gadgets. So we were very unhappy that they were using gadgets. What about the 20% of the people who are harming themselves and they are harming their brain without them knowing? And I also agree to them because we have to fix a schedule for us, because what is the point of waking up till 3 and doing our work? We should finish our work early and then start in the morning. That is the best way. And also do yoga in the morning, early morning. That also helps us very nicely.
I totally agree to Ojas. As you said, we can complete our work if we wake up early and we won't have to be awake till 3 a.m. or 2 a.m. to complete our work. And we also have to break that chain as our school's open. We have to wake up at 7 o'clock. So we can't sleep at 3 and wake up at 7. So we have to actually break that chain.
Thank you, Arush, for stealing those words out of my mouth. You know, when we talk to our children, the conviction that we give is you have to write your exam in the morning. So it's important that you set your body clock in such a way that you are most active in the morning, especially during the hours, you know, say 8 to 12 or say 10 to 1. Those are the hours when you'll be writing your exams. So that's what we've been telling our children also. And children, it's really appreciable the conviction that you are putting in whatever you are saying. I think you totally believe in what you are putting together here in your presentation. And for this, you really deserve a good round of applause. Yes. Well done, children. Very well. And it was great to be a part of this program. Wonderful.
I'd like to add on one little thing, children. Very often, children of your age feel that if we are not connected on our apps or connected with the social media, we will be isolated. But I generally use a term which says disconnect to connect. You need to disconnect, bache, from all this to connect with yourself, connect with the people around you who matter. So it's very, very important and a brilliant session. I don't know what take back you are taking. We are taking a lot of take home theories and we're taking in a lot of good technology words from you looking at sleep. And God bless you all. Keep doing this good work that you're doing and spread the word around in your age group. That's what, you know, all organizations are looking for, that with what we touch one mind, we are able to touch hundreds. So keep doing that, Sita. All the best. Thank you so much.
And ma'am, I know we have time constraints, but I've been wanting to add this for a while now, that the things that we mentioned, using gadgets, sleeping at 3 a.m., I, being a teenager and considering that I'm quite elder than all these four people, I have personally been through all of this during examinations and everything. And during the research part, I realized how important it was for me to not sleep. I won't lie that I slept early yesterday as well. I slept at 2 a.m. And now I'm realizing, listening to all these people talking so seriously about sleep, that how important it is to have a sleep schedule myself. Because what if, though I managed to wake up early and attend this session, what if I would have not been able to do so? The entire 15-day hard work would have just gone to waste. And it is very important for us teenagers, because the other day I was reading an article just because of the research, and where it was mentioned that our generation, especially even my friends, have kind of normalized the pattern of sleep schedule. They think that it is cool not to just sleep 3 to 4 hours and being on gadgets and using social media, it is cool. Whereas the reality is complete and far distinct from what we think it is. So I really, really enjoyed whatever like these like interns gave me the input. I'm also an intern actually. I was just guiding them. So it was a very wonderful opportunity to learn about sleep, which like we often take for granted. So it was like very informative and educative for me as well.
See, I also slept at around 1 yesterday, I'm not gonna lie. So I was like, yeah, I will wake up. But we had a practice meeting at 7:45 and I thought that was late because I was not able to sleep. So I didn't wake up and we had to cancel it.
Thank you for your honesty, children. I hope this will go on to a better mode now. You'll all have a fixed and definite sleep schedule.
Actually, thank you, because if we didn't get an opportunity like this, we would not even know that we slept at 2 a.m. in the night and it was harmful for us. We just thought that, okay, we will wake up late in the morning, but that's very bad. Thanks for giving us a chance for doing this.
That is not important. The people is only using the gadgets for waking, so not sleeping till 2 a.m. Some people start doing study also because they, before then exam day, they need, I need full marks, and studying whole night. That is the exam time, they does not concentrate on question as well as.
And I also completely agree with Yash. Like he said that we sometimes study at night, but in the morning it's our exam day. We forget everything and our minds.
Excellent. We are going short of time. We have the next presentation. Teamwork, excellent. Kanak, I always wanted that you should speak in front of jury, and finally you have spoken and you are my favorite. And I believe that you will be inspiring so many students in the coming future, and you will be making your life a very nice place for others also, because you are a kind of mentor that I always thought of, the kind of hand movement, the kind of energy you are having. Excellent mentor, excellent teamwork, excellent interns. Goodbye. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you all.
Bye, and thank you once again.
Bye, and thank you.
And YWCA.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank